One of the things that Asana has actually done is integrated with Zoom. And so in this video, I'm going to be covering and going through and discovering with you how this integration actually works. I've got my social media calendar project that I've created in other videos. If you're here for the ride, my name is Burhan and I cover all things online marketing, online business, and I'm here to basically help you become a little bit more productive, a little bit more efficient when it comes to using Asana and in this case, Zoom. I've got my project open in my board view and I've got the customized menu open, and under the apps feature here, we've got add an app, and you'll see under Zoom, it says new. Now, this was something I hadn't seen before, and so I wanted to do this video with you. So let's add this Zoom integration to the project, and it's giving us this sort of features. It's telling us what this integration can do to drive visibility and transparency. Here's what you can do in Asana with the Zoom app. Create and connect Zoom meetings to tasks. So that's an interesting feature, because when you set up a task, let's say you have a task to have a meeting with a client or with somebody, now you can actually create your Zoom meeting from Asana, which is very cool. And then post recordings and transcripts to tasks automatically. And of course, you need to be on a Zoom Pro plan. And then keep your team aware of discussions that take place. So let's connect Zoom. And so it's opened up this window and I've got to log in. And then it's giving me this window to authorize. And I hit authorize and it's now connected. And so now it's going to the next page. You've added Zoom to a project. Now that's important because it's to this specific project. To start using the Zoom app, open a task in social media calendar and look for the new Zoom field. Got it. Okay, so Zoom is now connected. It's taking me back to the project. And so let's create a new IG carousel from the template that we created. And if you want to watch the template video, definitely go check out the template video as well. And if I go to details, now you can see that I've got this Zoom meeting and it's given me this little pop-up that says add or create new Zoom meetings on any task in this project. Got it. So now if I wanted to add a Zoom meeting to this particular task, I can now add an existing meeting or create a new meeting. So this tells me that if I have an existing meeting inside of Zoom, that I can just connect that meeting using the meeting link or the ID. I'm going to add an existing meeting and I'm adding that here. It looks like it's synchronizing it. All right, so this is a scheduled meeting with my team. So now if I want to actually start this meeting, I can view this in Zoom. I can copy this link. I can send feedback. If I click on this link, it's now opening Zoom, which is very, very interesting. So just by virtue of the fact that I've connected this meeting, it now makes it available to me here. Now that's an extra step. What I'm going to do right now is remove it from the task and I'm going to create a new meeting. So what it's done is it's taken the topic or the task title. It's given me the options to choose the time. So if I wanted to create this Zoom meeting at, let's say, 6 p.m. Done. All right. So now duration is 1 hour and I'm just going to keep this at the same. I'm going to create this meeting. And so now it's created the Zoom meeting. It's given the task inside of Zoom. I can see that it's created the meeting as well. It's scheduled for today at 6 p.m. I'm the host. And so anybody who's got this meeting link can actually click on this to actually go to the meeting. Now that's very interesting, because if you've got clients, if you've got team members inside of your Asana working with you, and you, let's say you had an agenda and you created an agenda project, or you created an agenda inside of the project and you wanted to actually set a team meeting, then you could set that inside of Asana without having to leave Asana, which is the main point. Now what would be really cool is if I could set up a rule where anytime that I created a task inside of a specific project, let's say we've got a project specifically for meetings, then to create those Zoom meetings, that would be very, very interesting. Now, one of the other things that they said is to post recordings and transcripts to tasks automatically. Here's something else that's really interesting is on the Asana guide, it says that we would be able to see linked tasks inside of the meeting as an agenda. So during a Zoom meeting, opening the Asana app will show all tasks that are currently linked to the meeting. It's a great way to add tasks to relevant meeting agenda. See, they're discussed. When users open the app in the meeting, they'll see that the meeting tasks list. So this is inside of Zoom where we can actually see the tasks that are attached. And you can see that this is in the Zoom window. Now I haven't actually tested that feature, but I'm guessing that would be something that's really, really cool. Inside of Zoom, now we can actually go and add tasks and search for tasks and make notes inside of the task itself. Now, I personally don't know if I want to actually work inside of the Zoom meeting app. Like I said, for people who are working on a small screen and they have just the whole Zoom window open, that might be something that would be interesting. This is what I wanted to actually see, is linking attachments and transcripts. So once the meeting is in progress, click on the meeting details, we automatically get sent a link to join the meeting. If your Zoom plan has access to recordings and transcripts and your account has been enabled, Asana will automatically retrieve the recording link and or transcript and attach them to the linked task in Asana. If you link the meeting to multiple tasks, all the tasks will have the attachment. Okay, so basically what it's saying is inside of this particular task, this Zoom meeting, which is now happening in the future, will actually change to be a link. We'll have a link to the recording once the recording is done. Now that's actually pretty cool. Let's say you're using the social media calendar for a podcast recording and you've set up this podcast recording inside of Asana. You've invited your guest and the guest has the link. Now you and your team has access to this particular project. What we can do then, which is actually very fancy, is have Zoom already bring the link in and the team would have access to that recording. So then if we wanted to change the status to, let's say, editing, we would just change the, you know, depending on how you set up your rules or how you set up your Asana, what we could do is change the status from idea to editing. And that would mean that the editor would get notified. They can go directly and grab that Zoom link, download the recording and get to work. So those are some very efficient ways that we can actually get Zoom into Asana, where now we've got our meetings almost automated in a way that we get the transcriptions, we get the recordings inside of Asana from a project that's actually set up. Now, the main thing there is that the project is actually set up in that way, that it's connected and that you have Zoom connected. So now the question is, can we actually connect Zoom to multiple projects? I've just created a second test project with a test task, and I'm going to go here to customize, and you can see there's no apps connected here because the Zoom app is actually connected to the social media calendar. So because it was integrated already, it's already now added the app in here. So I can use the functionality in the same way as I did before, which is pretty interesting because now I can have Zoom in the projects that I want to actually run Zoom meetings, or that I know that I have Zoom meetings that are going to happen. And so actually the fact that I didn't have to go through that whole process to actually connect the two again was really, really neat. As long as it's in the same workspace, then Zoom can be connected to as many projects as you want to, and you can add and create meetings as needed. I would suggest is have one project for meetings and you'll be able to use that feature as and when you need it. So with that being said, thank you so much for watching the video. Definitely hit the like if you liked it. This was very interesting for me to just be able to collaborate with you, discover with you how this Zoom feature works. I'm really glad that Asana actually integrated Zoom, and I'm pretty sure there's a whole lot of tools that I will be covering as well. Go check out the playlist over here. We're actually covering more Asana tips and tricks and tactics to actually be able to manage your teams better. And I'll catch you on the next one. Thank you so much.